Okay. I remember we were hunting. We have more hunting to do. We have a lot more hunting to do. We're gonna do some other stuff first, though. Because as much as I enjoy hunting, we have to go back. Actually, I think I might already have. Did we get Protect Ga? I think I did. But I don't remember. Check Ga's white. Fran. Yes, okay. So we have Protect Ga, so that's one of them. So I need... two of the spells we're not going to be able to get until we get into, like, back into progression. Two of the spells are in the freaking Great Crystal. And one of them we also might already have, because I didn't check. Do I have silence? I don't think I do. Yeah, we need to get silence. That fight against that crystal and how it so handily beat my ass kind of showed me how bad we need to have the ability to shut down caster types. So we have to go to the Dalmasca Ester Sand, which is going to have us backtracking back through all this bullshit. Yeah, we've got, like, the dude that's fighting with weapons that have no reason being in this world. Although I can't really say that, because, like, whose place is it to say what weapons are allowed to exist in Ivalice? I'm just waiting for the ray guns, if I'm being completely honest. You need to go full might and magic. Give me some spaceships and blaster rifles. I gotta play Might and Magic 6 one of these days. I'm, like, so torn, once we finish The Witcher 2, about what I'm gonna play next. Part of me really, really, really wants to play Neverwinter Nights, Hordes of the Underdark, but then it's like, Might and Magic. I like Might and Magic. Might and Magic 6 is a good game, unless you're a Lanarain, in which case you just make a really bad party and whine about it for 20 hours. But we don't talk about him. He's German. Hey, Philosophizer, welcome. I hope you're doing well today. Glad to have you on board. Oh, loot the chest. There we go. So what was that I just picked up? I think that was some armor. Maidwin gear. Mystic armor tier 7. So that's probably not an upgrade to anybody. Well, I mean, it would get him a point of strength at the cost of... Well... It would get him spell points. I'm actually gonna... I want to give that to him. Get him near 500 spell points. I need another Sage's Ring, that's what I need. Those things are way too good. Guys, don't pick a fight with the damn Dark Elemental. Alright. You're not wrong, Byakko. Like, they're gonna be doing Final Fantasy 16, whatever the next one. They've said that they're going to be going back more towards, like... air quotes, traditional Final Fantasy. So, like, what does that mean? Because these games have had techie stuff in them since the original. I don't know. Alright, so we're in the Wester Sand. Now we have to get to the Easter Sand. Which may be through Rabanaster. It is, in fact... Rabanaster. I'm not happy about this, but it's the way of things. Can we just take the airship? Please let me take the airship. Oh, thank God. I wouldn't mind a Final Fantasy game again with like a job system and stuff to it. My interest in Final Fantasy 16 is purely going to be based on the combat system. If it's still like the hyper-fast, wannabe action RPG crap, I'm not gonna play it. I cannot stand where they have taken the combat in Final Fantasy games. This is about as quick as I want it to be. Alright, so we want to go to the Yardang Labyrinth, which I assume is this area to the south, because it looks somewhat like a maze. Look at that. Found it on my first try. I do have to restate once again my distaste for them hiding otherwise very useful magic all over the world and expecting me to go, like, pump chests in obscure places to find spells that you kind of really need to progress in a reasonable way. There we go. Okay, silence acquired. That's one down. So up next... Oh, up next we're going to the Great Crystal, which is gonna be...
Wunderbar!
Oh, hey, there's the German. Hello, Elanare, welcome. Hope you're doing well again. Jesus Christ. Chat being invaded by angry cat boys. The angriest. Yeah, Final Fantasy XV's combat system really, really missed me. I don't know. Like, the combat system was eh. The story, like, I understand why a lot of people really liked it, because, you know, it's a bunch of friends going on a road trip and saving the world in the grand scheme of things. And the game had some really cool set pieces. It was just... I don't know. That game did not grab me at all. Like, it's interesting seeing how Square Enix is handling the Final Fantasy series compared to, like, how Dragon Quest is being developed. Or, like, Dragon Quest plays almost the same now as it did, you know, way back when. They have some extra systems, but by and large, the core of the game is still there. And then you have other things. We'll go to the Western Sand and we'll just teleport. Okay. And this was... Was it the Pharos? Or was it Giravagan? I have no idea. We were just talking about you, Elanare, and how you couldn't make a party to save your life in Might and Magic 6. Oh no, this is- okay, so this is boss area. Alright, this is like actual progression. We fear this area. Alright, you're vegan then. I've got teleport crystal to blow. Man, Dragon Quest XI is so good. Holy crap. That game is probably, I would say, from a gameplay standpoint, the best traditional JRPG I have ever played. Hey, Solidarity, welcome. Glad to have you back. Hope you're doing well. Man, I don't want to run through all this crap again. And then I'm gonna have to... Oh, this is gonna be bad. Wizardry 7 screws everybody. You don't need to feel bad about that one. And Might and Magic 10. The less said about that, the better. Like, Might and Magic 10 is one of those games that you can build a party that's bad and you won't know it until 15 hours into the game, and then you're 15 hours in, and then you just never play it again. Also, I believe it has, like, some serious trouble running on current-gen computers. Like, there's something about how they developed it that makes it, like, super crash-prone or something. I don't know. I played it at release, and I enjoyed it for, I don't know, 10 hours or so, and then just stopped. I don't remember it being a bad game. Just very forgettable, I guess. Which is pretty par for the course for what Ubisoft has done to Might and Magic, since it fell into their hands. Actually, while my mind is on it, I'm gonna dink around with gambits here. So can we... Can we... All right, I need to get Fran more Gambit slots. Okay, because I need her to protect God of the Party. Fran. Just do like ally any and protect God. Okay, so now Balthier. You don't have to do this anymore. There, now we got, we should get Fran. There we go. Yeah, look at that, bubbles. Bubbles for days. Then we need to get Shelga, which is... We're running through the Great Crystal to access both Shelga and Hastega. So this is going to be worth it, it's just going to be... Petulance. We appreciate you regardless, Peaches. We appreciate you regardless. The plot in this game, like, is chunky as fuck. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, I've been playing this and I maybe 60% know what's going on. Yeah. Shit's complicated, yo. You of course know, Alanare, now that you've told me not to tease you, that I'm going to spend the entire stream teasing you. I will, however, say that Hila's plot synopsis is probably pretty close to the truth. Bug where you can't progress in the game because something in the data weird. Like, it chaps my ass. Might Magic 10 got done dirty. One of the big selling points of that was that it had modding tools, but then they're like, yeah, if you want to use the modding tools, you have to license them from us. And the license was like $10,000. And so it's like, well, I mean, you want to completely fucking kneecap your game, Ubisoft's showing you how it's done. Could have had something neat with a big fan community behind it, but greedy fuck's gonna greedy fuck. And there you go. Don't say that, Peaches. He'll show up. He's like fucking Bloody Mary. You say his name three times and make a really bad pun, he just appears. I have no idea what they thought they were doing, Philosophizer, but it didn't work out for them. My assumption is that they had to charge that much for it. If I had to guess, because it would be because the air quotes engine or whatever that they built it on probably had some software licenses tied to it. And to be able to share those with people, they had to charge. That is my thinking. It's still fucking bad, but I'm sure that there's a reason behind it beyond just corporate greed. I'm sure part of it is probably corporate greed, but I'm sure that there's legalese behind it too. I know, Asbestos, I am just dragging the worst of ass. And like, we're not even working on progression now. I'm going back to an area I hate so that I can get some spells that will tentatively let me kill things better and keep the rest of the party alive. Although at this point my AI party is just running off and killing everything because they can. I really do not want to go back to this place, and yet here we are. I'm gonna get lost again. I don't know how I managed to get out of here in the first place. Oh god, fucking Vaan. Still level 8. Gonna be level 8 until we finish this game with his 3,000 license points that are never gonna be spent. Okay, so. The areas that we are looking for in here are Fulum Prati Va and Fulum Prati. So it's not this one, apparently. Jalam Prati Va? No. Yeah. Because heaven forbid we have a map or they name areas in any way reasonably. Kaboni Jala. What the fuck? This area pisses me off. That's what this area does. Ooh, a morning star. Nope. Teleport me, magic stone. Take me to not here. This game needs a teleport spell. That would be great. So when you inevitably get stuck in a stupid back-ass where it's giant crystal, you can just leave. Nope. Upside is that we kill the hell out of everything. Have I soured on Final Fantasy XII? Oh no, absolutely not. I adore this game, I just hate this area. And I'd hoped we were done here. Sadly, we are not. And these area names are just so bad. So bad. Like, I might be backtracking right now. I don't know. I probably am. Kaboni, Jalam, Prativa. No. Oh my lord. Rama Vakari, no. Another teleport. Alright, I know where we are. We're like at the end of this place, yeah. I think this lets us get out right here, maybe. It's the town of Scorpio. No, this is not where we want to be, though. I can tell you all that. Wow. Our hireling is gaining levels. How convenient for us. His daily charge will go up. Now he's charging us like 50,000 gold pieces a day. 50,000 gil a day. Thankfully, we can afford it. Oh, this is terrible. And now, wait, Gate of Fire. I totally did. I totally just backtracked. Oh my god. I really wish there were any rhyme or reason to how this fucking hellscape works. But there's not. All there is, you know what? No. Where's I need a mouse cursor. Give me my mouse cursor. Internet. Final Fantasy XII, great crystal map. Oh my god. Hey, thank you very much for the follow, I appreciate it. Can I have a map that actually works, please? That doesn't just give me a 403 forbidden? No? No? That's useless. What a map that's not like 640 by 480. Oh my sweet fucking Jesus. Kinda like just view image. Alright. This is actually telling me where I need to go. How the fuck did I navigate this? Just look at this. Look at this! There's like fucking teleports and teleports. I don't even know. Not only do I not even know. Adobe Fulham Prati. It doesn't even. Get out of here, Water Fox updates. Nobody likes you. Like, this doesn't even show me the areas that I need to get, like, for the spells in here. Like, they're legit just not on the map. Oh my god. Final Fantasy II. How about, like, Zodiac Age? Great Crystal. Preferably in a resolution that isn't pies. Oh man. I found a better one. This is fucking terrible. Hey, look at this. So, like, I don't know where we are in this, but, like, look at this. What developer thought this was a fucking reasonable idea? Oh my god. All right. I hate everything. Where are we? We are in Stana Scorpio. Sounds like a fucking Bond villain. Stana Capricorn. We're probably still in like the first area because I'm an idiot. No we're not. Oh no. Stana Scorpio, okay. Alright. I am incredibly confused, but okay. This is going to take us to Aprama Vakari, tentatively. Okay. And this will get us the hell out of here if we want to leave. So where do I want to go? Adobe Fulham Prati? Jesus Christ. Okay, so it actually has noted on the map where the things that I want to be are. And naturally they're all, like, way the fuck in. So... I think we want to go past Gate Scorpio, but I don't know how. I'm the guy that made Final Fantasy XIII a series of long corridors. Honestly, I would rather long corridors than a giant teleport maze that doesn't give you a map. At least a series of long corridors is playable. How did I get through this? How did I, like, manage to navigate this crap the first time? This should be Da Vakari Broom. Yes, okay. And this will take me to Avakari Kabani. If I'm reading this right. But I don't think we have to go this way, actually. I think we can go back the other way. I'm just, yes, okay, all right. Alright, I understand how this map is laid out now. That means we can navigate. So, there's that gate put up. I think the gates reset when we leave, by the look of things. What I want to do now is just backtrack. And with the map, this should be... probably not reasonable, but okay. Apparently there's an Excalibur in here, too. You bet your asses we're gonna get that. I think Bosch can use it. Okay, so, gate here, and there should be a thing in here that will open it. There's also a really good bow in here, which we might already have. Is it the Artemis bow? She's using the Traitor's bow. Alright. I think we found the Artemis bow last time, and then I died? We wiped, and I lost it. No! God damn it. Activate the gate. For my master's chosen no other, the way will I open. Alright, well, open up. Alright, here we go. Okay, so now we should be in Da Vakari Kabani. I'm an idiot. We're an area short. Now we should be in Da Vakari Kabani. Yes. Yes. Maybe? Please? Okay. Alright, I gotta scroll the map up a little bit here. God almighty, this gets convoluted as shit. Okay, so now one exit. In the 1999 Tomb Raider 2. I mean, a lot of old games are like that. Like, how did a young me get through a lot of things? Bosh, you gonna do anything, Bosh? You're stopped. Why is nobody unstopping you? Be nice. Thank you. Our DPS is around. Alright, now you gotta wait for people to die. Because Doom is inconvenient. Where am I? Okay. I don't know where the Waystone takes me. We're not gonna find out. Come on, people. Die already. We're waiting on you.
I failed.
Alright. Patience was part of it, yeah, but at the same time, there was also, like, some stuff in old games was just shitty and, like, kind of put there to pad them out. Like, there's something to be said for having patience, and then there's also something to be said for games just, like, flat out wasting your time. Okay, so... Christ. Activate the gate. Okay, so now we want to backtrack. And which of the ones we go through doesn't actually matter. They both lead to the same area, it's just different portions of it. And there are three things we're going to want to get here, some of which we may have already gotten. I don't know. Supposed to be open. I just hit the thing to open them, unless I didn't. Pretty sure I did though. Okay, we're just gonna run past fights because I don't have my time wasted. Yeah, there was a boss where we just like cheese bombed through it somehow. Many Phoenix Downs were employed that day. Uh-oh. People are dying again. Friggin' bombs doing what bombs do. I do have to say that I quite like... Oh, God. Redis. You better fucking res somebody, man. What am I doing? I'm so confused right now. And no! It begins. Item... Where's my Phoenix Downs? Phoenix Down, Fran, Bosh, Bosh, get her out of here. Alright. Bosh, why are you just fucking standing there, dude? I would really appreciate it if you would act, and by act I mean murder everything. Here. Undo that. Fucking murder thing. Oh, they're all dead. To say, like, what's going on here? I don't know why all of a sudden Bosch has decided he doesn't want to kill. That's like his one thing. Okay. Nope. Now we should be back in the center area. Why are these gates here? Like, I literally just hit the thing to turn them off. And they are still here. And this portal is going to teleport me... I mean... Jesus Christ. We'll try. It's gonna teleport me way the fuck into the place. Must be a corresponding device elsewhere. Ugh! Even the map is not, like, making this easier. Oh my god. Okay, so there's nothing over there. No, do not fight the bombs. It's back on. Is it timed? Guys. Oh my god. This is very rapidly becoming something that I do not have the inclination to do for a couple buffs. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know that this is worth Shelga and Haste-ga. I must say. Even with a map, this crystal is garbage, and whatever developer thought it was a good idea should be, like, beaten. Alright, we're just gonna get out of here. Like, Shelga would be nice, but realistically, I don't think we're gonna need it. Haste-ga would be really nice, but I want to enjoy my time playing this game, and anything dealing with the Great Crystal is like the opposite of that. So let's see, the spells are in boss land, so we're not gonna do that. And the last one is just tied behind hunts, so we've got a bunch of hunting to do. And even that, realistically, I don't think we need to do. It's just bubble, which doubles your hit points. Which, while I think would be hilarious on Bosch, probably unnecessary. I don't know that I've ever really found any JRPG daunting. At least in a mechanical sense, I guess. Like, time investment, sure. Oh, well, no, I take it back. Like, the Shin Megami Tensei games, those are nuts. But those are nuts for different reasons. Those are nuts because those games hate you. I mean, the Persona games are not too bad. They have room for min-maxing if you want to do that. I've heard good things about the, like, Trials in the Sky games, too. Trials of Cold Steel and those. But again, like, I don't want to dump 100 hours into a JRPG. There are games I will dump 100 hours into. I do not regret dumping 100 hours into, like, Fosh. He's just standing here doing nothing. It says he's ready to attack, and he's just not. I don't know. Like, I dumped 100 hours into Kingmaker. Well, it was 80, but a lot of hours into Kingmaker, and that was okay, but somebody's like, hey, you want to drop 80 hours into this JRPG? And I'm like, no, I don't. I think in part, it's the characterization. Like, especially in stuff, like, where it leans more into, like, anime tropes and stuff. I just cannot care about games like that, for the most part. Tales of Berseria was pretty good, but that was because you played, like, a party of evil bastards. Like, that was great, but, man, I should stream a Tales game. That could be fun. But then the shippers would come, and I'm sure that would be bad. I'm actually pretty pleased with how chill everyone has been with regards to this. I was expecting a lot of, like, JRPG fanatics to be in and, like, bitching about everything throughout this entire playthrough, but I have had zero complaints. I know it's because of my esports tier gaming skills, but I don't know. All right. I mean, I guess, realistically, we can go fight some bosses. You're just here for my bitching? Well, I mean, you're one to talk, Alana, right? just save? No, I didn't. Oh, there we go. Alright. Teleport me, Crystal. Take me to the boss fights. I don't know. I do want to start playing more JRPGs. The problem is that most JRPGs are just too damn long. Like, a lot of them don't know when to quit. Although, in a lot of cases, though, it's mostly due to just having a shitload of side content. Like this, we're probably going to be done with this by 30 hours. Then you go into, like, how long to beat, and they're like, a standard playthrough takes 60 hours. And I'm like, no, it doesn't. Jesus Christ. No, it doesn't. What is this? Altar of Night. The beast here dwelling oft possessed black orbs, herewith approached by thine offering sealed the way to open. Oh god. We gotta get orbs, and then we get goodies for it, maybe. Exactly. Like, a lot of JRPGs, like, even the old Final Fantasy games, like, you can get through, like, Final Fantasy VI in, like, 25, 30 hours. But then you've got the people that are like, nah, man, you're not playing it right if you don't do, like, all of the side everything and turn it into some 150-hour extravaganza. Just like, no, I just want to play the game. I appreciate that there's hunts and side activities in this, but I'm not going to do them all. I'm just here to stab monsters, get experience points, and be confused by the story. Games. I haven't played a Lufia game since, I think it was maybe 2 on the Super Nintendo, Rise of the Black Sinistral or whatever. Yeah, RPGs are kind of my bread and butter. Solidarity. Like, since I was very young, RPGs have based, like, the RPGs are what I go to. Like, they are my type of game. Like, some people like strategy games. I like action. I like RPGs. I look too, you bastard. I gotta play something. Oh, it was a mimic. I gotta play something really bad and then he'll show up. Like, if I start playing, like, Divinity Original Sin 2 again, I'm sure Celt would be back in chat in a heartbeat. I do know on Fridays, though, that he's typically over trolling Cinnatar, and I can't blame him. Cinnatar is a better streamer than I am. But here we are. Doing here? Are we just, it's like the whole purpose of this area to give us the dark orbs. Like, I noticed we've picked up a couple of them. Yeah. Picked it up and I saw it go like floating off. No! There's one right there! Let me pick it up! Oh my god, the control. I wanna pick up the orb and Bosh is like, I must kill. And the camera's like, you can't see anything. There we go. Touch the orb! Alright. You got a black orb, you guys. The only thing that that'll do is ensure that I won't play your game. Very simple. I mean, if it's only one map and it's not necessary for progression, I just avoid it. But put it at the end. Oh, you fucker. This. Carven pillar. Ancient letters hang in the effulgent glow. Benighted child and chosen with life so short, the tower freely may you tread. In your passing, learn of truth. In your passing, speak of truth. These words writ by hands undying. Alright, sure. Oh my god. The romance between me and Celt is never to be. He can't afford to feed me. I've actually been toying with the idea of making something that plays like Might and Magic 2. Because, like, realistically, that game, from a mechanical standpoint, isn't all that deep. It's just an excuse to make the numbers go bigger. Like, that could be just a fun little side project, but that would require me to do, like, programming that isn't work-related. And I haven't done any programming in probably over a year. It's... like, yeah, work is killing me. This is what I'm trying to say. Like, I have just not had any desire to do anything in my free time. Like, even keeping up with Let's Plays has been a struggle. But here we are. Alright, so we've got a bunch of these black orbs. There's a side area over here. Magic 2, X this guy, oh man. That'd be crazy. Get like the damage numbers up in the billions and shit. That could be pretty cool. And like bring in a bunch of weird bosses from all kinds of series and get sued by everybody. Use a black orb. Alright, the first seal has been broken, so there's probably one on the other side. Well, no, there is one on the other side, so is it just two seals? I can deal with that. Two is a number that is within my wheelhouse. Alright. No, I didn't mean to read the inscription! I'm not here to read, I'm here to use the black orbs. Okay. Where are we exactly? The wellspring. Okay. Did that... oh no, there's a little side room in the back that I apparently walked right past. Because I'm good at video games. We're apparently not ready yet for the elevator of mastery here. Low seeker of heaven's path, setting out hearts of darkness shall light your way beyond vigil of the three houses, stand threshold of night and watch or both. Alright, so yeah, we do need a third one. Damn it. I don't know, I'm just saying, there need to be more RPGs along the vein of, like, the old Might and Magics. That is a vastly underserved market, I think. Oh no, there might be one in here, too. Because, like, everybody went on the, like, dungeon crawler kick, where everybody was making things like Grimrock and stuff, like the old Dungeon Masters. But the old hack and slash crawlers, like Might and Magic, the only one we've seen is Legends of Amberland. And it's like, come on, I just want to run around and kill the fuck out of everything for, like, 15 to 20 hours of gameplay here. And they're like, no. It makes me sad. So, apparently... apparently, I'm gonna have to do it at some point in the completely indeterminate future. I'll have to hire some kick-ass pixel artist to make me shitty monsters with like three animations that I loop through at random to get that proper old-school feel. That's exactly it, Alanare, that is exactly it, and it is crazy how satisfying that gameplay loop is. Like, it just blows my mind. We open the threshold of night. Knock, knock. Give me your loot. Well, I mean, really, Peaches, animating is just making shitty pixel art that looks like other shitty pixel art. Bearer, first ascent, the dunes of profaning wind. Dude, we found the fart chamber. Oh, no. Oh. Oh no, it's another area with no map, but it appears that this one just doesn't want me wandering off the beaten path. And Bosch is disabled. I don't even know what that means! Okay, but seriously though? I want off Mr. Bone's wild ride, please. Oh, is it these giant black things? I can't get near them. Is that what does it? Yeah, okay. All right, we're figuring stuff out. Go up this way. Well, I mean, Peaches, look at, like, the animations in, like, Might and Magic 2, like, from my Let's Play. The animations in those games aren't complicated. Oh, nope, that's bad stuff. And, I mean, realistically, before I even did that, I would want to get gameplay stuff done first. So you'd basically just be fighting text boxes. Uh-oh. Uh-oh! Turtle Rock! Oh, I was making a joke. Okay, but seriously, what? Pandemonium. Oh, I don't like this. Throw money at it! That just did 10,000 damage. Cost 10,000 gil, but... Yeah, some of the enemy designs in this game are a little too esoteric for me, the turtles being one of them. Oh no, it's power spinning! Okay, this thing's gotta have some gimmick to it, because, I mean, we're probably over-leveled by like 10 levels or something, but... Oh, it's... Alright, it's immune to everything. Okay, here's the gimmick. So how... Was this just temporary? Does gil toss work? No. Okay. It is an angry and vulnerable turtle. Cast doom. Alright, it's no longer immune to everything. Combat resumes apace. So that boss just has an ability, they might as well just call it padding. Because that's all it was. Oh no, Belthier, as per protocol, has died at the very end of the boss fight. As the fates decree it, Turtle, being unable to see, rushes into the rocks, promptly dies. There he goes. Magic spell gun. Okay. Dang gun mages. It eats through photosynthesis. Can we get an F in chat for the turtle? Not Balthier, he gets nothing. But that turtle tried really hard. This game. I got nothing. I got nothing. Oh, Asbestos coming in with the cruelty. The magic's binding the Waystone Fade. Welcome back, Balthier. You missed the good part. This room, the whole purpose of this room was just a boss fight. I don't even know if that was a boss fight we had to do. Or if it was just like, hey, you want a boss fight?
Hey kid, you ever seen a turtle with no head?
Ooh, a chest. Pair of Hermes sandals. Oh, are these like permanent haste or something? Oh, they totally are. Accessories 20. Well, Bosh, I would love to see you with permanent haste, my friend. Where's all your accessories at? They're right there. Oh yes. Oh yes, and this is why we just kind of hoard thousands of AP. And he's finally upgrading past the bangle. Aw, oh, feels good, man. I'm excited. Secret agent sound effects are very satisfying. Absolutely. I'm loving that game. I mean, it's like Crystal Caves HD, so I went into it knowing that I was going to enjoy it. Which is why I had it follow up freaking Dangerous Dave. But now I'm excited to see where that game goes. It's already a lot more difficult than Crystal Caves was. I'm telling you, Byakko, the turtles in Ivalice are plants. Bosh once more disabled. Apparently if he's disabled, he can move but not act. Or loot. Oh no, it was a mimic. Fair enough. Hasted Bosch is a scary thing, but I'm thankful he's on our side. He's like Chunk in Dragon Quest. We're glad he's on our side, but if he goes confused, he just kills everyone in one hit. That is not where we want to go. Leveling. Because we need more levels. We are, I think, already over-leveled for the final boss. If my recollection is correct, the last boss in this is level 50. But it's me playing, so we need all the help we can get. I don't think we're gonna finish this today. Maybe next week. Oh, okay, so we opened that. I gotcha. I wanna save, though. And I have no idea what we're gonna play after this. You're not wrong. I enjoy being able to just be like, you know, go into the final boss fight and completely curb stomp them. It feels good in its own way. Do we need like green crystals now? Is that how we're doing this? All right, Wellspring Ravel. There's something, the holy spell is in here. It is on the third flight. We want that for obvious reasons. Oh, door just opens. Okay, sure. I was expecting they wanted something from me. I'm thankful that they don't. You who crawl upon the clay, yet yearn for heaven's path made by our will. Tongue of stone's green flame, your way bespeaks. When stone face lit by green flame falls, then flame returns to stone, the path is clear. Alright. So we're probably gonna have to kill something green. Drag Vaan out and sacrifice him on the rocks. Oh, okay. They have green flames. I see what you're doing. Yeah. Thanks, I hate it. A quality stone. This is like a +3 rock here, you guys. Very high quality. Like a crap load of potions. Oh, I see that chest over there. Don't think I don't. 126 gil. Truly, it was a chest of disappointment. Okay. This is kind of a clever little gimmick to make me walk around and kill everything, I guess. Collecting hundreds of gil to go along with the tens of thousands that we are running around with otherwise. On paths you must rely on, by path of living flame have you come. Frozen in stone, the green flame passes from time, stone now and evermore. So is that telling me that once I kill these things it'll stay a path for as long as I need it to? Because that would be nice. What happened to backtrack? That'd be great. Coming to halfling with a sling. Oh god. I don't want a goddamn Kender in the party. That'd be terrible. I should, like, completely, well, I guess kind of unrelated. I should be having Bosch steal from bosses. Like, I know specifically when... I can't remember if Gilgamesh is someone you have to fight in this or if he's a hunt. He might be a hunt. But I know, like, the Genji gear in this game, the only way to get it, I think, is stealing it from Gilgamesh. Oh, I don't know. I should have Bosch do that, but effort. That's right, give me those levels. On sight must you rely at mercy of the currents of the fading world. Seduced by false illusion, it is the fool who cuts not his own path. Celestial glory ne'er to behold. Alright. I don't know about you, snarky sign, but I'm just walking around killing everything that dares get in my way. Feels like it should. I was gonna say, this feels like it should be something. Hit the wall. Dark Souls taught me sometimes you gotta punch the wall. Alright, we won't be going that way yet, though. I wanna see what's up here. Or is this anything too? Oh, it totally is. Okay. Like, legit, just a little show. What the fuck? What's the point of that? Oh, we got a chaperone. What is a chaperone? Chaperone? Here, let's just go. The items. I assume it maybe is a weapon? No. It's a helmet. Alright. Light armor 10. A fancy hat that I don't think anybody wears. Yeah. Gives you a bunch of health, though. 600 health. Not bad. Hey, B-Cat. Welcome. Hope you're doing well today. Glad to have you on board. Okay, we are on the second flight. We want third? Yes. Ow! Just gonna let this play out. No. Apparently the dragons are less than friendly. Okay, so third flight. So holy is in here somewhere. We wanna keep an eye out for that because death magic for Fran? Why yes. I'm glad to hear that. Glad you are doing very well. Oh, where are you guys hiding holy at? Is this holy? No, it's an X potion. Disappointing, that's all that is. Ah, and a hole for me to throw Vaan down, I suppose. That looks progression-y. No, come on, guys. What is this? No. What does your sign say? Oh, wingless child consigned to walk the world below, many are the works whose natures a duality possess. When stone face lit by red flame falls, then red flame turns to stone, the path is clear. But stone born of green flame through darkness fades. Alright, so if we kill one that has a red flame, it's gonna get rid of all the green ones. So all of our walkways from the green. Good to know. Surely this isn't going to be a point of contention and or frustration at any point in time. Oh no, it's another dragon. Ah, these things are terrible. That's right, eat the back row. They like the damage. Look at Balthier, look at his fucking face. Gotta say, flyers are obnoxious. Oh no, 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 no. Do not attack that guy. Do attack this guy. Attack this guy. Now wuss out, because we do not want to kill you. Yeah! Screw you, game. Freaking chicanery. Alright. There's another red flame one. Fran, I don't know what you're doing back there in the background, but you need to get with the rest of the party.